This is the video for experiment 7, analysis using decomposition reactions. And we'll go to the pre-lab review page, first of all. And question one, are there any safety alerts? Well, you'll want to look for the triangle icons as you read that experiment. That'll help you answer that question. Number two, are there any specific disposal directions? In this case, you'll look for the garbage can icon. And the rest of these questions in the pre-lab review, I think, are pretty straightforward. And I don't believe you'll have any trouble with them. On number six, I give you a little clue. It said the word approximate is a clue. But if you go back to question five, we see that word approximate, and that's a clue that will help you answer question six. Seven and eight, again, I think are pretty straightforward. So let's look at the data and report pages. A decomposition reaction, you recall, is where you take a material and it breaks apart and gives two substances, B plus C. And in this case, part A, we're determining the formula of a hydrate. A hydrate is a combination of a chemical substance with water. And we're going to determine how much water is bound to that chemical substance. So as you gather data, you'll look at the photos that are associated with the lab. You can read the photos to the thousandth, and so you'll want to record your data to the thousandth. Here's the mass of the crucible plus lead, and I've just labeled this as X over here to help us a little later on. Then you'll record the weight of the crucible, the lead, and the sample, the hydrate sample. And of course, it will be more. Again, you want to record to the thousandth. After you heat this substance to decompose it, you'll have a final weight, and we'll label that as Z. Lots of math in this experiment, but it's not complicated, and hopefully we can simplify it even beyond that. When you work up these numbers, you'll do so in Table 7.2, the report part of the experiment. Let me bring both of these back on the screen. The mass of the hydrate sample before heating, I tell you it's Y minus X. So it's this largest number up here, minus the weight of the crucible and lead. And again, you'll want this number to be to the thousandth. That's obeying the principles of significant figures. If these numbers are to the thousandth and you're subtracting, you'll have three significant figures there in your answer. The mass of the sample after heating will be Z minus X. That'll help you a little bit. And again, we want three significant figures. It'll be expressed to the thousandth. This next number, the mass of the water produced, while we're driving off water, here's the weight of the hydrate sample, the weight after we've driven off the water, and so we'll subtract to get the mass or the grams of water that were produced. Our number's expressed to the thousandth, but notice now that we've got just two significant figures. These leading zeros are not significant. Here's where we do some calculating. The moles of water produced, well, here I have 0.081 grams of water. I want to convert that into moles over in the right-hand side. And in both of these calculations that we do here in this experiment, we'll use the factor unit method. Here's the number that we're given, the unit that goes with it, grams of water. We want to come up with moles of water, so moles is in the numerator. And in one mole of water, using the periodic table, there's 18.0 grams of water. So notice, as we multiply this times our factor, grams are going to cancel, we're going to get moles of water. And I don't know what that number is. I didn't put it over here. And it's sort of meaningless for me to do so because remember that all my numbers are hypothetical. They're usually correct to the number of significant figures, but they're just hypothetical. Your numbers will be similar, but different. If I were to calculate the moles of barium chloride, well, we'll take that 0.415 grams of barium chloride. And again, we'll use the factor unit method. We'll put moles in the numerator so that we get that as the answer. Down in the denominator, we want grams of barium chloride in one mole. So grams are going to cancel. We'll get moles as the answer. And I've labeled that as number B to help us a little bit in the next calculation. So two significant figures here. Three significant figures here. In A, we'll want just two significant figures. In B, you could have three significant figures. The ratio of the moles then will be A over B. And because A only has two significant figures, you'll express A over B to two significant figures. The whole number ratio, well, a whole number means 1, 2, 3, etc. But again, we'll want to use significant figures. And so if you determine that the whole number ratio was 3, you'd want to write it as 3.0. Or if you determine that it was 2, you'd want to write 2.0. Then finally, to conclude this part of the experiment, we've got the formula of the hydrate. Here's the chemical substance, barium chloride. The period or the dot indicates that there's a certain amount of water that's bound up with the barium chloride. And depending on what your whole number ratio is, if you determine it's 1, you'd put a 1 here. If it's 2, you'd put a 2. If it's 3, you'd put a 3, and so forth. Hey, let's go to part B. In part B, we're decomposing potassium chlorate. And I've written the formula here for the decomposition. One starting material, two products. KCl is a solid, but oxygen, of course, is a gas. It's going to be given off. So we'll have a starting weight or mass of the starting material. And then we'll have a final mass, which will be less, because some of the oxygen, well, all of the oxygen has been driven off. So up above, again now, we'll want to record weights to the thousandth. Here's some arbitrary numbers. I'll label this one X. The mass of the test tube and sample before heating is here. Then the mass of the test tube and sample after heating is here. And we'll use these numbers down below now. The first blank in the reporting table calls for the ID of the unknown. And remember, when you enter ChemWeb, that's the student lab number, a four-digit number that's given to you each time. The mass of the unknown sample that was heated is going to be Y minus X up above. We'll record that to the thousandth. Mass of oxygen produced, it's going to be Y minus Z, and again to the thousandth, three significant figures. To go now from grams of oxygen to moles of oxygen, we'll use the factor unit method, one step, write down the number that's given, the unit, then employ a factor that gives you the unit that you want for the answer. Moles is up here in the numerator, so that'll be the unit of the answer. With grams in the denominator, grams are going to cancel, and we'll get moles of oxygen. And I could have labeled that as A over here, but I didn't. Moles of KClO3 decomposed. I'm going to take the moles of oxygen and convert it into moles of KClO3. We'll use the balanced chemical equation to do so. Notice in this equation the coefficient 2 and the coefficient 3. This tells us that 2 moles gives us 3 moles. So we're going to have to use that fact when we do this calculation. We're starting with moles of O2. In the numerator, we'd like moles of KClO3 over moles of oxygen. That'll give us B, and which is moles of KClO3. The next calculation is again just one that where we'll use the factor unit method. We want to go from moles of KClO3 to grams of KClO3. So we use this number B in moles, multiply by grams over moles. That'll give us C. We're just about there, because we're going to use C now to calculate the percentage of KClO3 in the sample. And we want 3 significant figures. That's what we have up above. So C over our beginning mass, that 0.326, so it's the part over the total times 100. That's the formula for percent, and express it in 3 significant figures. So hey, lots of math, but if you use the factor unit method, it's not tough at all. Let's look at the questions at the end of the experiment. These are pretty hard and will take some thought. So I've tried to give you a clue for most of them. And they're quite detailed, but I'll just read the clues for you. How would that affect the moles of water lost? So read number 1, and then as you weigh each of these responses, A, B, and C, ask yourself, how would the error that's been indicated up here affect the moles of water lost? In number 2, the tip is moles of barium chloride would be less than correct. How is that going to affect the value of N? And number 3, when is the accurate sample mass determined? That'll help you. Number 4, I think, is straightforward. Number 5, hey, here's a hint for you. The water removed by drawing will be counted as lost O2. Number 6, the hint, the lost mass will appear to be lost O2. And that's it. Lots of calculations. Some tough questions at the end. Hope you have fun. Remember that you can email me or call at any time.